Welcome to Rusty X channel. I need to rebuild the battery for my electric bike. So I'm looking for a spot welder to weld 44 18650 batteries. I tried 3 DIY spot welder solutions and found the MCU controlled high current relay solution is the best. The first solution is a MCU-controlled MOSFET solution. I viewed lots of videos and bought this board online. A MCU controls 5 parallel MOSFETs, which can drive a large welding current. There are buttons and a screen to adjust the welding energy. To be precise, adjust the welding pulse width. There are 2 operating modes, automatic trigger and manual trigger. The automatic trigger function is very convenient. I think I'm not lucky this time. At first, the power switch had a problem. The switch is not self-latching. The board automatically turns off as soon as the hand is released. After trying many times, suddenly the switch can work normally. I tried the functions with a small 12-volt 2.1-ampere battery. After a few welding attempts, I found that the MOSFET is stuck on. I think the MOSFET is damaged and stuck shorted inside. To be honest, I still like this solution and hope the board can work more reliably. If this solution works for me, I won't try the other 2 solutions. Because the 18650 batteries are alive soon, it is too late to arrange a replacement board. So I quickly took the second plan, the super capacitor solution. 2 500 farad super capacitors are in series, which can provide up to 5.4 volt welding voltage. The lab power supply is responsible for charging the super capacitors. Balance boards are used to protect the super capacitors. I found 5 volt is about the right voltage for welding. Welding quality is affected by the welding time and the strength of pressing. Both of them are difficult to control. If the pressing is too hard, then the welding time is too long. If pressing is not strong enough, then the welding contact resistance is too large. If the welding time is too long, it will burn a hole on the nickel and the joint is weak. If the welding time is too short and the joint is not strong enough. In addition, my lab power supply provides up to 2.5 amp current. The charging time is too long, and it takes tens of seconds to charge between welding. In summary, I don't think it is a reliable method. so I give up. The third solution is MCU controlled high current relay solution. An ESP8266 chip on SONOFF SV is used to control an 80 amp high current relay to provide the current required for spot welding. I use SONOFF SV board just because I have one. And this board can be directly connected to a 12 volt power supply. Also, it provides relay output to directly control high current solenoid. In addition, ESP8266 can load ESP Easy firmware, so you can easily adjust the parameters through the web page. This is the code used to control the welding. The program is based on the ESP Easy rules. It outputs two pulses when the button is pressed. The first pulse removes oxides on the surface of nickel strip. The second pulse then welds the nickel strip to the battery. Now let's take a look at the trial welding. The solder joints are very strong and cannot be pulled apart by hand. From my experiment, the MCU controlled high current relay solution is very simple. It is the most reliable solution amongst the three, and the welding joints are very strong. Hope this video is useful to you. Please click like and subscribe to support me. Thank you.